you can see the role is only for local, and there's some data and diagnostics you can put in here. So it records your actions, and it has some IntelliTrace hooks, so you can also capture IntelliTrace from your net data. If you don't know what IntelliTrace is, it's a very, very powerful debugging tool for Visual Studio. And they're using that for a lot of places. You can also ask it to capture what's happening in the event block. You can even configure all of these things so you only want to capture the system information in event block or whatever it is you specifically need. And you can record the test impact. That means that it records which executables have you put in the air. And if they are later going to change some code in one of these executables, then they will highlight this test case as being one of those that you might want to execute again. And last but not least, there's a video recording. So, I made a deep diagnostics. I wanted to capture the event log, I want test impact, and I want to record it. So, let's go back to our test case. And I want to run this with options of going into deep diagnostics. Now, I don't know if you saw, there was a little warning sign at one of the steps before, which meant it didn't record that action step. So I can't ask it to just execute everything, but I can show you the principle here. I guess it's my moving around the screens or something that made it. So, I don't know if you saw this before. This little thing here, that was grayed out before, because there were no action steps. This time we have a recording. So, I want to play the next step. The recording is in action, and it is, of course, in action there. So what it did was it opened Internet Explorer, and I will show you. If I can find my mouse. So it opened Internet Explorer. Cool. Yeah, so what? I mean, so what? It opened Internet Explorer. But if you had 30 steps here and you knew that there was something interesting at step 12, you could ask it, you could highlight 12, 11 of these steps, ask it to play there, see what the status of the system is in, and then execute manually the last step. So that's why that's interesting. Another reason why the playback is interesting is that if you have a test case that have been going well on one of your configurations, you have recorded it, then you can play it back on another configuration. So you don't have to actually do all the steps because it's playing it back for you. Yeah, so that's fairly interesting. So you have, let's say, semi-automatic execution of it. So that's pretty interesting. But let's move on here. I need to say yes. This goes well. We are the decay. That did not go well. And what we wanted to do was go into some deep diagnostics of what's happening. So news is in fact not present. That's what we want to prove with this. So So we have a test page. We want to create another one or update the one we have. Yes. So it gives me a box where I can search for an existing bug. So I want to find. News when not present. Add. And it pops up with the bug where you can now see that this one was the one I executed first. And here it comes again with the new steps. And this time it actually has a video recording. Whoa! What just happened? Yeah, but once it's finished the thing, what can we do? It has captured your movement of your mouse. It's really interesting here because it's of course captured my primary screen. So yes. So there's of course something that you need to be aware of. So it doesn't grow into the sky with the great things there, but you just have to be aware of it. It recorded. So you have all these things recorded for all these things blocked for. So that's pretty interesting. You get some recording, you get some diagnostics, you are able to execute your steps again without having to go into them manually. A lot of good stuff, but there's something better. I'll show you that. Close down these windows here. Yeah, it's all my family there. Same results. And I want to show you something. That is interesting from an exploratory point of view. Because sometimes it just isn't feasible to make test cases for everything you execute. Like, if you want to go through a site seeing if there are spelling errors, or if you want to put in some, well, actually this one is a little misplaced because you do want to make parameters for test cases for this one. But let's assume that it's something that, yeah, you're going through it, you are visually verifying that things are looking right. That would, you wouldn't make test cases for all of that. You would have one test case and you would go through it and with an exploratory approach. So, if we say we have this test case, and it's sort of made for exploratory testing. I want to execute this. We'll just show what's in it. No test steps at all. And being an exploratory test case, it doesn't have to. But I'll show you why this is really a nice thing to have. Because when we go in here, we have our test case. We choose to run. So you see there are no steps here at all. say, I understand this completely wrong. So. Come on. Because I need to do this. So we have this this test case where we need to search for weird crooked things. So I'm starting up this browser here.